Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco again, back for another video. And then today, what I wanted to do is explore an application called process.st. Now this is an internal wiki tool that is actually, I actually discovered it when I was working with Barbara from Simplifying Days. She was using it as her internal wiki to provide the team with all the information they need to know without necessarily having to nudge each other all the time. Very similar to applications like Tetra, Slab, and of course, Notion. So this will be a walkthrough of process.st, giving you a bit of an idea of how to understand the application. We're also going to be giving it the most suitable recommendations near the end at whether this is an application for your business. So before we begin, a big thank you this month in July 2019 here on Keep Productive. We are sponsored by Monday.com. Now Monday.com is an intuitive team management platform created to fit any team and manage anything. Why do teams love Monday.com? Monday.com is easy to use and get set up, and you can pick from hundreds of ready-made templates or build workflows from scratch. The platform is so customizable that it can be adapted to any situation, no matter the industry. It's used by a whopping 70,000 teams worldwide, from WeWork to the Discovery Channel. It's ideal for just two people building a business to a large-scale team looking to centralize their efforts. Now, curious about how it works? We've done a walkthrough that can take you through the application, the key features, and how it will affect your team life. You can download Monday.com. And to get the ball rolling, if you want 10% off, you can get it in the link in the description. So thanks again to Monday.com for sponsoring this month here on Keep Productive. So guys, let's dive into process.st. Now you can find process.st at process.st. It is an application that was started back in 2013, so they've been around for a little bit of time now. Probably one of the more long-term wiki tools that have been out there. Now, sort of tagline is to help teams with recurring checklists and processes. Again, it's this internal wiki tool that will help you to monitor and manage all of the information that your team needs to know. And what I would say is it's a very robust solution from being able to use it. And it does have a huge amount of workflows, which we'll be diving into a little bit, but we'll actually be doing a separate video on that to sort of dig deeper. Now, the goal of this internal wiki is to minimize training costs, produce recurring checklists, and also to improve siloed information that might be available through your Slack. So let's touch on the pricing before we begin. It's $15 per user per month for the business plan, which gives you a 14-day free trial. There is a free plan, of course. They don't actually make that aware to you at the start, but it is available. And they do have it only available through the web version at the moment, but they are planning to release mobile editions according to the team. So just to touch on security as well, because I know a lot of people get worried about security. Amazon servers, they use RDS and S3, and they have a good security page that outlines everything. And from what I've read online, they've had a good record in terms of security and making sure your information is safe. So we're actually going to start here on the homepage. So you can see that you get two main tabs, the homepage with all of your sort of templates and starting information, and you would building that out. And we're actually be doing three demonstrations today. And you also get an inbox as well. And an inbox is where you're tagged in tasks, and that's really easy to do. So you can obviously see assigned by me, or you can actually, actually break it down into the different departments per group or per email. So we'll touch on that a little later. You've also got upcoming as well. So these are tasks that you might have future planned, and you can also search tasks directly here too. Okay guys, so here we are with process.st, and what I wanna do with you guys today is sort of explore the core features of this application. So we are here on the home area. There is two main areas, there's home and inbox. I'll come to inbox near the end as we begin to assign ourselves some tasks inside this application. As I said, this is more of a checklist application. We'll be touching on the automation side of it in another video because I believe it needs much more attention than initially sort of created. Now you can go ahead and create a blank template. This essentially allows you to create a brand new checklist or template to get you started. So for example, if we wanted to start it on content writing checklist, We can do so, and this will be stored inside of the home area if you don't have any folders. So just to get you a basic understanding of the core sort of experience in being able to create a brand new checklist, is over here you've got the steps, so you can add as many steps as you like. Each step has a title. So for example, we want to say maybe title creation, because this is an article. Then obviously that's going to be step one. Step two is a brand new area. So image selection for header. This is all obviously relevant to the content writing. You can add a description up here if you want to add a bit more detail on it, obviously modify the title. But if you want to be able to obviously go in and change things, you can obviously see that you've got this tab on the right-hand side called content, and you can drag in relevant bits to build up that page. Now, very similar to an internal wiki like Notion, you can obviously add and build onto this with images, videos, files, subtasks, but you can even add send email. And there's relevant form folders too. So for example, if you wanted to create a checklist, for example, for anyone that is new to the company that needs a new laptop, that needs to get things started and be able to fill in some forms that is relevant to that, you could use the forms section to create a really useful guide on how to do this, and then actually set up an automation process. So for example, when they've filled in that form, they can send it to the HR department to go and order the specific laptop that they need. So that's just a good example of how it can be used. So we're going to really touch lightly on the basic settings, and we're going to go into the pre-made templates, because I think this is where a lot of the magic is. You can assign it to a specific person. You can assign it to multiple people, but let's say you wanted to group it by department. This could be it's for marketing, not finance. But you can now have multiple sort of roles for them, which is good. And if I wanted to, I could go and see who's exactly been invited and remove them. So you can see this is a marketing only item. So actually, that's really helpful, because you could even add a finance process like paying, for example, paying a contributor. And this obviously would be assigned to the finance side of stuff. So it's actually really helpful for managing the process and actually being able to make sure who's got what. And you can even give it due dates if it's very needed. In this case, it actually doesn't need due dates, but it's very simply, you can see when the task will be due and how many days, or after, you know, for example, the checklist start date. So you can actually add some before and after conditional formatting, which is a dynamic due date. You can add a stop as well. For example, if you add a stop, it means that this task must be completed before this task, a bit like a dependency, which does help you to process stuff. And you can modify the permissions here. You can invite relevant people, the guests, the share links, and even add permission down here to specific people. So you can see here that that's a custom setup. So for example, you could have marketing, finance not even seeing what the marketing are doing, just by going to the custom setup and adding permissions to marketing only. And if I remove the all members, you can see that there. So in this case, it's visible to marketing and anyone that has a share link or is a guest inside of the workspace. So that way the finance department won't be able to meddle or see any of the specifics in the stuff that they don't need to know. So if I press save, obviously it saves the template revision. And if I go back to home, I'll show you that in a second. You can see it appears at the top here. Now, if you've got a few settings, if you wanted to have an automation, for example, like running the checklist, you can do. Again, we'll be touching on that in a separate video, because I believe that's a bit more detail. You can obviously run the multiple checklists, schedule the checklist for another time. If you wanted to schedule it, it means that you'd obviously be able to have to repeat it. You can also change the, for example, this could be useful for like a set routine that you have in the office, like cleaning, no, not cleaning, I don't know, something that is office related, like, let me try and think, like an administration task, like submitting for awards and things like that, something that requires a routine process. I probably use really bad examples there. So if I go to more, I can add it to the public library, I can archive it, I can move it, and I can even export them as CSV, which is quite helpful. I can add relevant tags. So if I wanted to add a tag like content, I could add a tag there, and that is brilliant. I could even add a Yammer group, which means that any of the comments and additions to it is updated inside a Yammer group, which is, I guess, like Slack. I've never actually heard of it. But the cool thing is, if I wanted to, so this is the more like view as edition. So this is an editing, this template. You can actually view it here and be able to get into a bit more detail. You can even see the times it's been run and the status of the project. Now again, run checklist, I'm really doing it not as much grace because I want to do a full video on this one in terms of getting it a bit deeper. So obviously down here, you can create a folder on a new tag. You can see tags appear down here, so you can filter down specific things for each department or each topic. But I'm gonna go ahead and create a new pre-made template. So let's say I wanted to do the podcast publishing checklist. And this actually has run this checklist to publish your podcast. You can customize it. So all you have to do to actually modify it is just to press customize and it will copy it to your home area. Now this is really useful because once the template's imported, you have access to it. So you can see here that somebody's made a really intricate and quite long 59 checklist points and actually be able to create headers in there. So the way you create headers is just by adding a colon after it, and it'll create these bold headers, but these are a good way to separate the content. So you can see all the facts here for the podcasting, and somebody's created this really, really useful guide in actually creating podcasts. But you can see here that obviously you've got some videos included in here. So this is a really good internal wiki example of how to get started. And of course you can go in and edit this template. Let's find another one because I want to show it in a bit better light, employee onboarding. So this might be useful for a department that's have a new employee come on board and want to be able to set a process to having that new employee come on board. So here you can see you can contact the employer candidate. So here let's go into the edit this template. So if you see contact the candidate, the first step is to touch base with the new employee. Use the form below to record their name and email. So in this case, you might want to add their name up here and their email and when the meeting is required. So if I go back to save changes and for example, I'm in this process, I'm like, okay, I want to be able to add this. If I press run checklist, you can obviously get started. So once you run the checklist, it will make all of those forms available. So here we are running our first checklist. You can actually go and see, obviously you can start so you can complete the task or you can just go to next. In this case, I'm gonna complete the task. You can write comments, you can attach stuff, but let's say I'm gonna complete the task. So obviously it goes to the next area and there is nothing here. That's just a heading. So if I wanna say the employee name is Bob and it's bob@bob.com, and I want to set a meeting date, I can do so for tomorrow maybe. And there we go. So I can complete the task and you can see that I can go to the next area. And you can even add all the reference information, like sending all the relevant details of the person. And I can skip forward and I can even check things off. So I can always be like ticking it off to be able to, you know, make sure that I've followed all these using the candidates, what date I gave the offer. So I can save that there and obviously I can actually send a confirmation email using the widget. So for example, what I have to do to send that is it will connect up with your mail application. In this case, it's actually loading up Swift because I've got that set up. So I'm just gonna edit that out there. So it can actually set up send email, which is amazing, using variables. So obviously I can prepare the offer letter here. I'll actually show you how we can sort of set this up and how this is actually set up inside of the checklist afterwards. But you can see a progress bar up here of everything happening. But you can also upload the offer letter, upload the sign, you know, and download certain samples, which is quite cool. And that will be sent away to them, which is really handy. So actually, this is not just an application that helps you to use an internal wiki, but the checklists actually help you to do a process, actually go through a workflow and forcing yourself to send the relevant information. So that's really, really handy. Now, if I go to complete checklists, you can see a little celebration for the completion of the checklist. And if I go to home, So if I go to home here, obviously I've done the employee onboarding. Let's go and edit this one and see actually what was included. So for example, the prepare offer letter. It's very simply a file to be uploaded here and required as well. This is really useful. And also having the file as well down here, you can actually add ones to be downloaded, which is really helpful. Now for that, that actual sending of the email, I believe that was in contact the candidate. Oh no, it's in contact reference. No, it was in offer. Bloody hell, it was in offer there. So all I had to do there is add a few variables. So for example, the form, employee email, and also what you're actually gonna be sending. So for example, in this case, congratulations to the name of the employee, which has been brought in from here, which is very smart. So they've connected up these variables, really, I guess, a little bit more intricate than, say, just a regular application. So to add a variable, all you need to do is press these like magic icons near the items and be able to add them in. So for example, if I want to say, after you got the interview, you've got the job, and then let's add the employee name. So employee name, there we go. And you can see here that obviously when it comes up, it will say you've got the job, Bob, fill in all the blanks. So that's really, really handy. And we saw that in the relevant. So guys, Process Street is a really interesting application. I will be touching into the details more because I think it's more of an advanced application than I initially thought. I was using it really as an internal wiki inside of using it with Simplify Days and the team, and it was actually really useful, but we never used the run checklist, or at least I never used it. And it would be something that I think I want to do a separate video on, digging into how you can create these run checklists, because if you're looking at this as a resource to get started, hopefully this gave you a nice walkthrough or overview of it. Please do let me know in comments whether you are or will be using this application. There's a link in the description that you can use to check out Process Street. And you can find all that. But this can be used for anything from content writing, client onboarding, weekly tasks, and even some templates and workflows that you have in your team. And you can connect it up in a really advanced manner. Anyway, guys, we'll be coming back to this. So please do let me know in the description whether you want me to touch on a specific topic. I will happily, happily help. Anyway, guys, thanks so much. Talk to you soon about Process Street. Thanks to Monday.com for sponsoring. And I'll see you guys in a future video. Cheers, everyone.